We were doing potentiometer. Who will tell me the principle of a potentiometer that we did yesterday? Yes. What is the principle of a potentiometer? कौन बताएगा? What is? Yes, Shivam, बोलो.
The potential difference at the one portion of potentiometer is directly proportional to the length of that that portion of the potentiometer, provided the uniform current applied to it.
Yes, very good. So potential difference across any portion of potentiometer wire is directly proportional to length of that portion of wire, provided uniform current flows, constant current flows through uniform wire or through wire of uniform area of cross section. Yes, that is true. So after that, who will tell me what are how we can check whether we have connected all the connections in the correct manner? How we can check whether we are going to obtain the balance point for sure or not? Yes, who will tell now? How we'll come to know that the connections that we have made are correct in case of a potentiometer? Yes, students, hurry up. Who will tell? I told you we will bring the jockey in contact with A point and B points, right? If the deflection is in opposite directions, we would come to know that the connections were all correct. Is that okay? I told you, जब तक deflection opposite directions में नहीं होगी, we won't be obtaining balancing point. तो हमारे पास balancing point नहीं आएगा तब तक. All right. So, I repeat once again, students, please complete your project work till Saturday and upload the photo and video of your model in the physics group. All right. Those who have joined late, it is for their information. So next question related to potentiometer is that we did yesterday, that it is preferred over a voltmeter. Who will tell me the reason? Vidisha, why is a potentiometer preferred over a voltmeter? Yes, Vidisha. Yes, speak up.
Ma'am, because potentiometer gives us the exact value of EMF, whereas the voltmeter gives us the value when
because
the
potentiometer is based on null method, so it gives us reading when no current is being drawn from the cell. So that means it gives us exact value of EMF of a cell. Whereas on the other hand, voltmeter, there is always a voltage drop in case of that. So there is only approximation in the value of EMF that we get. Right, so I hope that is clear to you. Now, next very important question related to potentiometer is, we did both the applications of potentiometer also yesterday. How we can make a potentiometer more sensitive? There is a term, potential gradient. There is a term, potential gradient, denoted by K. We did the principle of potentiometer that V is directly proportional to L. So the constant of proportionality is K here, which is potential gradient. So undoubtedly K is V over L, potential per unit length, or this is the potential gradient. So to potentiometer will be most sensitive when this K is minimum. We can make a potentiometer sensitive by reducing the potential gradient. So how we can reduce potential gradient? See, it is inversely proportional to length of potentiometer wire. So by increasing the length of potentiometer wire, we can reduce potential gradient, and hence we can increase the sensitivity of potentiometer. Okay, so note it down. How we can make a potentiometer more sensitive? By reducing potential gradient, and that will be possible if we increase the length of wire. So please note it down. This is very, very important logic, that why we are having 4 meter long wire on potentiometer, not 1 meter long wire like we have in case of meter bridge. Why we are using greater length of wire to make the potentiometer sensitive? Because by taking more length of wire, we are reducing the potential gradient, and hence we are increasing the sensitivity of potentiometer. Is that clear, students? So write this down. Why do we have, or you can write in this way, will a 10 meter wire potentiometer be more sensitive than a 5 meter wire potentiometer? 10 meter wala jo potentiometer hai wo zyada sensitive hoga ki 5 meter wire wala zyada sensitive hoga? So what do you say about it? So aap bologe ki 10 meter wire wala potentiometer hum prefer karenge because it will be more sensitive. Because of more length, its potential gradient will be much smaller. That is the reason. Okay, because of more length, its potential gradient will be much smaller and it will be more sensitive. So I hope this sensitivity of potentiometer is also clear to you. Any doubt about it? All right. So with this, we come to the end of this unit. Current electricity, a little bit about electric power that you have already done in lower classes, we can just recall. Electric power, you know, power is rate of doing work. So electric power is the rate at which electrical energy is being consumed or supplied. So likhiye, what is electric power? It is the rate at which energy, electrical energy, is being supplied or consumed. Electric power is the rate at which electrical energy is being supplied or consumed. It is the rate at which electrical energy is being supplied or consumed, because you know work and energy are equivalent. So work upon time means energy upon time also. So the formula becomes electrical energy upon time. So power is E by T. We use this formula, all right? And then Tushar is also coming now. Okay, so the SI unit. SI unit, you already know power is what? Denoted by symbol capital W. SI unit of power is watt. Named after Sir James Watt. 1 watt is 1 joule per second. Power of an electrical appliance is said to be 1 watt if it consumes 1 joule of energy in 1 second. You can write the definition of 1 watt. Power of an electrical appliance is said to be 1 watt if it consumes or if it supplies 1 joule of energy in 1 second. Other units of power are kilowatt, megawatt, gigawatt, horsepower. Kilowatt means 1000 watt. Mega means 10^6. Giga means 10^9. And 746 watt, that is the value of horsepower. You already know that. And in the end, which is the Board of Trade unit? BOTU. Have you heard about it? Who will tell me? What is the Board of Trade unit of electrical energy? What is the Board of Trade unit of electrical energy? Bataiye students. Come on, 9th में पढ़ा हुआ है आपने.
Board kilowatt hour.
Kilowatt hour, yes. Board of Trade unit means commercial unit of electrical energy. So that is kilowatt hour. Board of Trade unit of electrical energy, commercial unit of electrical energy is kilowatt hour. And you will remember that you also derived a relation with practical unit of energy, that is joule. So relation between commercial and practical unit of energy. Relation between commercial and practical unit of energy. That is between joule and kilowatt hour. 1 kilowatt hour is 1 kilowatt multiplied by 1 hour. 1 kilowatt means 1000 watt, and 1 hour means 3600 seconds. Watt is joule per second. Second gets cancelled, so we get 36 and 5 zeros. So 1 kilowatt hour is 3.6 × 10⁶ joule. 1 kilowatt hour is 3.6 × 10⁶ joule. Is that fine? 1 kilowatt hour is 3.6 × 10⁶ joule. And also, efficiency of any device. Efficiency of any machine, any device is defined as output power over input power into 100. For example, there is a pump that is lifting water through certain height. So when we plug it in, the input power is electrical, but when it lifts the water through certain height, then the output power is mechanical. So efficiency of any device will be ratio of output power to input power into 100. So symbol of efficiency is eta, P output over P input into 100. So this formula we can use. All right, we can use this formula. Further, you know, joule heat is given by H is equal to I square RT. Joule heat is given by H is equal to I square RT, or V square over RT, or VIT. You know that? Joule heat ke teen expressions hain. So accordingly, power is heat over time, because the Joule's law of heating is saying that whatever current we pass, whatever electrical energy we pass is ultimately dissipated in the form of heat. So when we put these three expressions of heat here, we get three expressions of power as well. P is equal to I square R, P is equal to V square over R, and P is equal to VI. P is equal to VI. And usually, output power is EI, you can write. Input power VI, if you can write like this, you can find the efficiency also. Okay, so just recall these expressions that you have already done in the lower classes. We might use in the numerical problem. So with this, our unit is over. Have a look. If you have any doubts, finally, you can tell me. Yes. Bataiye bachche, koi doubt hai? Do you want me to prove this H is equal to I square RT? Should I prove this? Chaliye, wo bhi kar lete hain. 2 minutes lagenge. By the definition of potential difference, it is basically work done per unit charge. All right. So the work is Q into V. This is equation number one. Using the basic formula of current, I is equal to Q by T, rate of flow of charges, we write Q is equal to IT. And using Ohm's law, we put V is equal to IR here. So put Q is equal to IT here and V is equal to IR here. See what do we get? Put in one. Q is equal to IT, V is equal to IR. So we get I square RT. And this work is done or dissipated in the form of heat ultimately. So we write joule heat H is equal to I square RT. H is equal to I square RT, and other expressions can be obtained by using Ohm's law. By using Ohm's formula, we can find other expressions. Got this? Clear, students? Now open your exercise, open NCRT. I'm going to share it. Open your NCRT exercise of current electricity. Yes. Are you able to see? 3.1, 3.2. So this is your NCRT exercise. So we'll be starting this now. Please tell me whether we have covered any questions before. Yes?
No, ma'am.
Okay, so let us start. 3.1.
Ma'am, paper mein ye theorems aayenge.
Kaun si?
Paper mein ye theorems to nahi na aayenge.
Theorem kaun si?
जो आपने अभी प्रूफ कराई है कुछ भी जो
ये
डेरिवेशन ही
आप देखो तो नहीं ना प्लस टू में इसके ऊपर बहुत कुछ है आपने देखा ही है ये तो आपकी टेंथ में बहुत इम्पोर्टेंट हुआ करती थी आपको पेपर में आता था प्रूफ जाउल्स इक्वल टू एच इज इक्वल टू आई स्क्वायर आर टी अब यहाँ पे तो यू हैव सीन इन दिस यूनिट पोटेंशियोमीटर इज देयर मीटर ब्रिज इज देयर किरचॉफ लॉज आर देयर कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ ड्रिफ्ट वेलोसिटी इज देयर कॉम्बिनेशन ऑफ सेल्स है तो वो इतनी सारी चीजें हैं 7 मार्क्स का पेपर इसमें से आना है आपको फाइनली तो आपके ये वाले आर्टिकल्स को फिर ज्यादा इम्पोर्टेंस नहीं रखते बट फ्रॉम पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू ऑफ न्यूमेरिकल यू हैव टू कीप इन माइंड ओके सो लेट अस कम टू 3.1 द स्टोरेज बैटरी ऑफ अ कार हैज एन ईएमएफ ऑफ 12 वोल्ट इफ इंटरनल रेजिस्टेंस ऑफ द बैटरी इज 0.4 ओम व्हाट इज द मैक्सिमम करंट दैट कैन बी ड्रॉन फ्रॉम द बैटरी तो मैक्सिमम करंट के लिए मैक्सिमम वोल्टेज चाहिए वो ईएमएफ होती है वो उन्होंने दी हुई है 12 वोल्ट एंड रेजिस्टेंस इंटरनल रेजिस्टेंस ऑफ द बैटरी इज आल्सो गिवन 0.4 ओम सो आई इज इक्वल टू जस्ट यूज ओम्स फॉर्मूला वी इज इक्वल टू आई आर सो आई इज वी ओवर आर 12 ओवर 0.4 120 ओवर 4 दैट इज 30 एम्पीयर ठीक है तो फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन आपका आ जाएगा 30 एम्पियर सी I is equal to V over R, E over R here because we want to find maximum current. So that is 30 ampere. So current is 30 ampere. Let us see second question. 3.2, a battery of EMF 10 volt. Please go noting down the particulars. Battery of EMF 10 volt. And internal resistance 3 ohm is connected to a resistor. If current in the circuit is 0.5 ampere, what is the resistance of the resistor? Means external resistance they are talking about. So capital R we have to find and also find terminal voltage, terminal potential difference. So these things we have to do just a simple formula we have to use, no problem. So use V is equal to E minus IR or you know this in the cell is always connected in series with the external resistance. It is always connected in series with the external resistance. So resistance of the circuit is capital R plus small r. Okay, so let us write I is equal to E over R plus R. First of all, find this out. Put in the values and tell me what is the external resistance. Yes. I'm waiting for your answer. Tell me what is the external resistance. क्या आ रहा है आंसर? सेवेंटीन ओम इज योर आंसर? सेवेंटीन ओम स्टूडेंट्स, यस और नो? आर यू सॉल्विंग साइड बाय साइड?
यस मैम, 17 ओम.
17 ओम ये आपका एक्सटर्नल रेजिस्टेंस आ गया. नाउ सिंपली यू यूज V इज इक्वल टू आई आर टू फाइंड वोल्टेज ड्रॉप, टू फाइंड टर्मिनल पोटेंशियल डिफरेंस. सो यूज V इज इक्वल टू आई आर हियर. ओके, यूज V इज इक्वल टू आई आर हियर. करिए सॉल्व, जस्ट मल्टीप्लाई हाफ कर दो इसका, 8.5 आ गया आपका. So 8.5 volt, that is terminal potential difference. Okay, that is terminal potential difference. चलिए 3.3 A part. Three resistors 1, 2, and 3 ohm are combined in series. कितना हो गया? 6 ohm हो गया total resistance. B part. If combination is connected to a battery of EMF 12 volt and negligible internal resistance, find potential drop across each resistor. So very simple question. Three resistors, 1, 2, and 3 ohm are connected in series and two 12 volt battery. Unke across potential difference nikalna. How will you do? Yes, I think you will be able to do in 2 minutes. Resistance of the circuit is 6 ohm. Battery voltage is 12 volt. So same current flows and potential differences will be different if this is V. So let us find current, total current flowing through the circuit. First of all, that is 2 ampere of current is flowing through the circuit. Then what is V1? V1 is IR1, because current flowing is the same, IR1. So 2 into 1, 2 volt. V2 is IR2, 2 into 2, that is 4 volt. V3 is IR3, that is 2 into 3, that is 6 volt. And if you add all the EMFs, 6 plus 4 plus 2 is again 12 volt, total 12 volt. So this is how we find potential drops across each resistance. Is this clear? Any doubt? Is this question clear, students? कोई doubt है तो पूछ सकते हो. चलिए let us see the next question now. 3.4. Now three resistors 2, 4, 5 ohm are combined in parallel. Find total resistance. तो 1/R करके आप निकाल दोगे. If combination is connected to battery of EMF 20 volt and negligible internal resistance, find current through each resistor and total current drawn from the battery. So 2, 4 and 5 ohm ke resistance hai, battery EMF hai 20 volt. Yes, start trying yourself. Hurry up, I'm doing here. So battery potential is 20 volt and R1, R2, R3. 2 ohm, 4 ohm and 5 ohm connected to 20 volt battery. So if I is the total current, then through different resistances, different currents will be flowing. So that I is equal to I1 plus I2 plus I3. But potential difference will remain the same. Across all the three resistors, potential difference is 20 volt only. So first of all, find total resistance of the circuit. Yes, take the LCM and tell me what is R2. चलिए बताइए, RP कितना आ रहा है?
19/20
कितना आ रहा है?
19/20
19/20 आ रहा है. Have you inverted it?
नहीं, 20/19
इन्वर्ट कर देने पर 19/20 है आपका 1/r. सो योर इक्विवेलेंट रेजिस्टेंस ऑफ द सर्किट इज 20/19 ओम. नाउ लेट अस इक्वेट द पोटेंशियल डिफरेंस थ्रू ईच ब्रांच इक्वल टू 20. सो V इज इक्वल टू I1 R1 इज 2, I1 इज we are to find, and V is 20 volt. So from here we get I1 equal to 10 ampere. Same way you find I2 and I3 also. Potential difference in each branch is equal to total battery voltage. Potential remains same in parallel. So tell me what are I2 and I3 now. And then you add them up, you will get total current I also. ठीक है, टोटल करंट तो वैसे हम ऐसे भी निकाल सकते हैं, आई इज इक्वल टू वी ओवर टोटल रेजिस्टेंस 19 एम्पीयर. सो टोटल करंट फ्लोइंग थ्रू द सर्किट इज 19 एम्पीयर. नाउ थ्रू वन ब्रांच इट्स 10 एम्पीयर. फाइंड द करंट I2 एंड I3 करंट थ्रू अदर ब्रांच. टेल मी व्हाट इज द आंसर. यस Aditya, will you tell I2? Aditya, what is I2? Aditya, बताओगे I2 कितना आ रहा है? Aditya, I2 बताओ कितना है? Aditya, Varun, how much is I2? ये देखिए 4 × I2 इज इक्वल टू 20. सो I2 इज 5
एम्पीयर
एंड I3 इज 4 एम्पीयर. एंड इफ यू ऐड 10 प्लस 4 प्लस 5 अगेन द सम ऑफ करंट इज 19 एम्पीयर. सो हेंस इट इज वेरीफाइड ऑफ. इज दैट क्लियर स्टूडेंट्स? फाइन. सो लेट अस सी नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन. क्वेश्चन 3.5. At room temperature, resistance of heating element is 100 ohm. What is temperature of element if resistance is 117 ohm? Given temperature coefficient of material of resistor alpha, 1.7 × 10⁻⁴ per degree Celsius. So alpha is given. Simply we are to use its formula and we are to find new temperature T2, right? If you remember, let me note down the values. So 3.5, this is T1 is 27 degree Celsius, T2 we are to find, R1 is 100 ohm, R2 is 117 ohm, alpha is 1.7 × 10⁻⁴ per degree Celsius. This is the data. This is the data that we are having. Okay. So use the formula of alpha, R2 minus R1 over R1 delta T. Find delta T from here by cross multiplication. R2 minus R1 over alpha R1. 117 minus 100 over 1.7 × 10⁻⁴ × 100. So that is 17. 4 zeros, 5 zeros rather. So we get 1000 degree Celsius. Delta T is 1000 degree Celsius. T2 minus T1 is 1000 degree Celsius. So put the value of T1 now. That is 27. So we write T2 is 1027 degree Celsius. This is how we find. So this is our final temperature, T2. So T2 is 1027 degrees Celsius. Is that fine? Clear? Now I'm going to share the screen with you, and please note down homework because the next 2-3 questions are based on this same formula. So you will try question number 3.6, 3.7. बस दो ही दे रही हूँ आपको और 3.8 थ्री क्वेश्चंस इसी फॉर्मूला पे बेस्ड सो प्लीज ट्राई 3.6 7 एंड 8 एंड वी विल बी डिस्कसिंग इफ यू विल हैव एनी डाउट्स इज दैट ओके स्टूडेंट्स सो फ्रॉम 3.9 आई विल रिज्यूम नोट डाउन 3.7 8 एंड 9 6 7 एंड 8 दीज आर असाइनमेंट क्वेश्चंस ओके स्टूडेंट्स कोई डाउट